up, Laura.
Going to the chapel and we're gonna get married. Going to the chapel and we're gonna get married.
Now leg out front, back. Is that too loud? Now tap. To the side. Here we go. Tap, tap. Tap, tap. That, then something's broken. All right, let's put our maracas away. Here's your favorite song, Gloria. Mine too, I love this song. Take a deep breath. Is that too loud? Okay, exhale, down to your toes.
Just hang there. Let your lower back open up.
Has come along.
Inhale back up to the sky.
Stretch that spine. Lengthen it like someone's got traction going on you.
And life is life.
And exhale down.
Inhale, back up.
The sky's above.
Stretch, reach, reach, reach. Now bring your arms down to the side.
My heart was wrapped up in
clover. Let's just put our hands on our lap and get ourselves in that proper alignment. Our ankles are under our knees, and our hips are under our shoulders. Our ears, they're right over our shoulders, and we put our palms up so our chest opens up, and we're just going to circle our nose around, warm up that base of your skull.
A dream that I can call my own.
After you do four, go the opposite direction.
To press my cheek to a thrill.
And back to center. Now let's take a deep inhale.
You smile.
And exhale, look into your left. Just however far you can go, whatever range of motion you have. You gotta start somewhere. Now, inhale back to center.
And here we are in heaven.
Exhale, relaxing those trapezoids.
For you are mine.
Inhale again.
At last.
Exhale to the right. And exhale. Now we're going to do the chin tucks. We just use this thumb of ours as a gauge. If you put your thumb right here, that's how far you want to go. You don't have to leave it there, but that's your gauge. We're just going to tuck our chin back with an inhale. Inhale. Exhale forward. Again, inhale,
was the light
tuck,
from the stars.
Exhale, forward, two more, inhale,
bluer than velvet were her eyes.
Exhale, try and relax with your exhales each time, last one, inhale, exhale. Now we're just going to take our shoulder sockets and we're going to rotate them around, relaxing those shoulders. Sometimes it helps just to close your eyes and get rid of all the distractions to relax. And last one. Relax that out by tapping our shoulders, tap, tap, and then fling your arms down, back up, and back, tap, tap, back, and last one, tap, tap, and back. Now let's bring our elbows together. We're gonna open, close, go down, and up. Open, close, down, up, last one, close, down, and up. Now let's just kind of work it out of our chest a little bit. Left arm, we're gonna do some circles. Wake up that shoulder socket some more. Get that fluid warmed up in your socket. After you do four, go the opposite direction. And when you're done, let's go to the other arm. Circle it around. Two, three. Now, opposite direction. And last one. Now, put your hands behind your back on your chair and come to the very edge of your seat. And open up that chest. And we're just gonna lift our right leg up and then our left. Find that beat and go to that rhythm, nice and slow. Warm up that hip socket. Now we're gonna add our arm up with the same side. Tuck that stomach in. Keep breathing. Make sure you're taking steady, deep breaths. And try and exhale when you scrunch your stomach. Three more. There's one. And last one. All right, let's walk to the back of our chair. We're going to take our right arm and we're going to just put it out to our side with our palm up. And as we flatten our hand, like there's, we're pushing it against a wall, we're gonna take our left ear and go to our left shoulder. Here we go. Flatten that arm out. We're stretching that median nerve, which prevents arm pain and that carpal tunnel problem. Now, inhale back to center, making a fist with your hand, bringing it all the way up to your shoulder, and lower it on down. Other side, palm goes up, and we're gonna flatten it out as we go to our right ear. Here we go. Flatten it out, and try and relax that muscle, and be gentle. It's just a nerve floss. You always do stuff that with your neck gently. Now, make a fist, bring it up to your shoulder, and bring your head back to neutral. And lower your arm down. Now we're gonna take our hand, and the back of our hand is gonna be in the small of our back. We're gonna look straight ahead and have really nice posture, lengthen that spine, like someone's got a rubber band on your head and they're pulling it up and stretching you, just like the rubber band. Visualize that. Now we're gonna stretch the other muscle in our trapezoid, that LS, that levator scapular. What we're gonna do is we're gonna take our head and we're gonna go to our left ear, same thing again. You should feel that muscle. Now we're gonna look down to our armpit, just gently. Now, do you feel that other muscle stretch in there? It's like tucked in the back of your shoulder blade. Now, bring your ear back to your shoulder and then bring it back to center. And relax that arm, kind of just wiggle it around, kind of relax that trapezoid and rotate it the other direction. Let's do the other side. The back of your hands facing the lower part of your back. And we're gonna go to the opposite shoulder. Here we go, right ear. Now look towards your armpit. And bring your ear back to your shoulder. And bring it on back to center. And kind of work it out on that side. And the opposite direction. Get some rib cage mobility. Open up your legs more than shoulder width apart. We're gonna take our left arm and just lean on our left leg. And we're gonna take our right arm. And first we're gonna reach really high, stretching that spine again. And then now lean it over if you can. Feel that lengthening on the side of your core. Now bring it back up straight, stretching tall, get off of your leg. Bring the other hand up, stretching, stretching. Now the right hand goes on your right leg. Reach up first with the left hand, stretching, and then lean it on over. And bring it back up to the sky again. Add your hand with it. Walk your feet together. Bring your arms down and tuck your chin back so you pretend you have a wall behind you. And do a couple of wall angels. Up and see how far down you can go without hurting yourself. Keeping that neck tucked back. And last one. And bring your elbows forward. Let's do some cat-cows. This stretches your spine the opposite direction. Here we go. Inhale. Take an extra sniff. Expand those lungs. Now exhale, put your hands on your knees. Tuck your chin down. Pull your belly button towards your spine. Stretch out that lower back. This is so good for your lower back. Now again, inhale on up. This time bring your arms all the way up like you're holding a big beach ball. Open that chest further. And exhale, put your hands on your knees. Tuck that chin down. Curl that spine. Now take your hands, pull them towards your body with sticking your chest out, squeezing those shoulder blades in the back, and then relax. All right, let's do another lower back stretch. Turn all the way to one side. That means all the way, both legs are going to one side of your chair. And we're gonna drop our right knee so it's off the chair. Only one cheek's on the chair. And we're gonna take our right hand and we're gonna make a straight line with it. We're gonna have our knee and our hip and our shoulder all in one line. And we're gonna inhale, bringing that elbow up, nice and stretched on the side, holding it. Now exhale and bring that elbow to your hip as close as you can. Feel that side of your core stretching. Now inhale back up. Unfurl your arm, and if you can, put your left elbow on your chair or do whatever you can, whatever mobility you're starting at. Just exhale over your chair. Now inhale back all the way up, stretching first, lengthening, strengthening. Now tuck under your toes. Your right toes go underneath, and your right hand goes forward. And your left is on your chair, or better yet, on your left thigh. We're opening up those hip flexors and that calf muscle. Fifteen, 29 and 30. Now the right hand comes back towards your body. Right leg comes up. Come around to the center. Put your hands on your chair and kind of stretch that out a little bit. And bring your right leg up and down. Two of those. Now grab your knee. See if you can bring it up to your chest further. Rotate your ankle around, wake that ankle up, and reverse. Now get that whole hip socket, two one way and two the opposite way. Now on the other side, all the way over. Left knee goes down towards the floor. Left hand is on your shoulder. We're gonna inhale on up. Stretching. Now bring that left elbow to your left hip. Inhale with the elbow up again. Unfurl your arms and go over your chair if you can. Now inhale back up, reaching and stretching and stretching first. Now tuck your left toes underneath and bring that left arm forward. Really press those hip flexors open. This is good if you sit for a long time. You should do this like 3 times a day if you sit a lot. It'll help your lower back. Behind your back, stretch out that chest, bring your leg up and down. Hand is on your knee and see how close you can bring it up. Feel that stretch. You probably already did that once today, putting on your shoes and socks, right? Let's get our bands out. All right, join me when you get there. Top of the world. Sing it. Last one. Now we're going to take our left hand and put it right here. We're going to take our right arm and we're going to put it on our right knee and we're going to squeeze that tricep towards the back for 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Five more. 4, 3, 2, and last one. Now we're going to tighten that stomach muscle, holding it nice and tight the whole time. Put your hand right here. We're going to take our right elbow up, and we're going to punch it out. 2, 3, 3 more. And last one. Now we're going to take our left hand, put it on our left knee. Really important to keep your stomach nice and tight and open up your legs more than shoulder width apart. Make sure you're sitting on those sit bones. And we're going to... Sure. A little loud, those Beach Boys, huh? How's that?
Yeah.
All righty. Okay. Right arm goes all the way up. Feel that oblique muscle in your stomach. Tighten it. There's 3. 3 more. 3, 2, and last one. Kind of work that out at your shoulder a little bit. Get a little tense there. Now let's go to the other side. Right hand's on your shoulder, right? And we're going to start at our knee, and we're going to work that tricep. You go back, scrunch it up, make it tight, and forward. There's 3, 4, 5. 5 more. 5, 4, 3, 2. And last one. Now we're going to take that same arm and we're going to punch it to the right or the left, excuse me. Punch it. There's 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and last one. Right hand goes on your right knee and we're going to hold that stomach tight to protect your back. Bring it all the way up. There's a 6. Exhale. Three more. And last one. Work that out. Now we're going to stretch out our area between our shoulder blades by putting our band on top of our knees. And we're going to exhale as we go down. Here we go. Downtown. All right, last one. Take your band and let's throw it behind our back. Stick that chest out. Your right leg goes out, then your left. Can't hear it? All right, keep going. Some songs are not as loud as others. There we go. Is that too loud, Phyllis? Each song is different. I'm sorry. Even if I gauge it on this iMovie, it's not accurate. last one. Back to center. Make sure your feet are flat. We're going to take our right arm and go over our left, and left over our right. Okay. We know that part, right? Downtown. One more on the left. We're going to use our ankles, and we're going to bring those heels up when we punch forward. Punch it out. Slow it down. Last one. All right, kind of work that out a little bit. Let's take our band, put it under our right foot. Remember that proper alignment with your posture. Gonna start with your right hand. We're gonna curl that bicep. And last one, left hand, nice posture. Posture's so helpful. If you have good posture, you usually have good balance. And it's nothing to do with age. There's young people that have horrible posture. Last one. Now, both hands at the same time. Hi, come on in. And both hands at the same time. Just lift it up and down. Two, three, four. Right towards the back office where the exit sign is on your left.
Okay,
yeah. All right, now push back and let's walk to the back of our chair and we're going to squeeze those shoulder blades together. Two, three, three more. Three, two, and last one. Now point and flex. Wake up that ankle. Two, three, three more. Three, two, and last one. Now twist your ankle, turn that baby toe in. And last one. Now I don't know if you're gonna be able to do this one standing up, but come to the edge of your chair and lean on the back of your chair. Stick your leg out straight. Make sure you keep your foot flat so it doesn't fly off in your face. And we're helping your knee here. Forward and back. Two, three. Try and have it all in alignment like you're walking. Your knee is in alignment with your hip and your knee is in alignment with your ankle. All right, last one. Now pull yourself up, nice tall posture, and put both feet inside the band. Make sure you're at the edge of your seat so you're forced to use your posture muscles. And there's a two, three, three more, three, two, and last one. On the inside, nice tall posture. Squeeze those shoulder blades together and squeeze your abdominal muscles. Protect your back. Exhale. Let's do five more. And two more. And last one, on the outside. Let's see how quiet we can be. Not too bad. Woohoo! That means you're using your stomach. Ooh. Yeah, it's the cowgirl song. Yeah, it's like a horse. Left hip goes up, right hip goes up, all the way to the back of your chair. Do that hip walk. Legs out straight, And do the shoulder blade squeeze. So good for your posture. Three more. Three, two, and last one. Now hips open and close. Feel that outer hip muscle, that gluteus minimus. Whew. Roy, sing it, Roy. And last one, pull again. Row that boat. Run like to me. And last one, back to the hip. Open and close. Squeeze those buns. And last one. Now drop that band, wrap it around your knees. Come to the middle of your chair. We're gonna open and close. Open, close. Oh, I don't know how he does that. Yeah. Now we're just going to hold it open. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, and relax. Now bring your band underneath your thighs. Put your hands through the handles, if you have one of these anyways. Open up your legs more than shoulder width apart. Squeeze those shoulder blades in back. Squeeze that stomach muscle first, nice and tight, right? And we're just gonna punch to the right. No twisting, just punching. There's a three, four, five, and last one, back to center. Other side. Six, five, four, squeeze that stomach. Three, two, and last one. Hands are in the center. Pectorals and our stomach muscles work here. Here we go. Up and down. Five. Exhale on the exertion. Shh. And last one, and down. Now put it under your tush and walk to the edge of your chair if you can. Hinge back just a tad. You should feel those lower abdominals engage about like right there, huh? Uh-oh, there you go, Donna. All right, I thought you would appreciate that. All right, we're gonna hinge back. And we're gonna lift up and down. Find that beat. Crunch that stomach. Crunch. Exhale. Shh. 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 Two more. Shh. And last one. Shh. Now work it out, kind of just shake it out. Under your left foot. We're not gonna make that 45 minutes, you guys, I tell you. You can't get it all in. I'm trying. There, I know. Nice tall posture. Left hand, up and down. Two, three, three more. Now we're on full speed ahead. All right, hand. All right, five, four, three, two, and last one. Now, the hamstring pull up and down. Feel that stretch. Three more. Last one. Now walk to the back. shoulder blade squeeze. 5, 4, 3, 2, and last one. Just doing the left foot and we're pointing and flexing. Just one foot. Two more. Now, side to side. Yeah, kind of curl that baby toe in. Twist into the side. And last one. Put your band above your head, and we're going to go bounce, bounce, center. Bounce, bounce, center. Add your leg. Opposite leg. Kind of bounce that foot in front. Work that muscle above your knee. I know, huh? One more on the left. And center. Now let's go down to the floor. Down and up. Two. Up. Three. Up. And last one and up. Now the fun part. You get to bean the new neighbors. Oh, I mean the neighbor, your neighbor. Uh-oh, watch out. Now you see where he gets his name, Trouble. All right, get your weights out. Let's just put them to our side as we're waiting for everyone to get them. Stretch out that trapezoid muscle. Take a deep breath. Exhale. Everybody got some out? One more deep inhale. Exhale. Now here we go. Up and down. Up and down. Up and down. Up. And last one, and down. Slow it down. Make sure you're sitting on those sit bones, not your tailbone. You have nice posture to protect your back. Go at your own pace. Last one, and down. Now, put your hands right here. And we're going to bring it up, out, in, and down. Really tighten your stomach to protect your back. When the weight is far away from your body, you can injure yourself. Keeping that stomach strong, you won't. Go at your own pace. If this is too fast, slow it down for you. If you don't feel anything after 10 of these, you don't have a strong enough or heavy enough weight. Let's lower it down. Let's let our arms hang down. Stretch that out a little bit. Now, let's bring it towards our stomach here. We're going to bring it up our body with an exhale and then lower it on down. Now, we're going to hinge back just a tad. Like we're trying to get on too tight of pants. Zipper that zipper up. Shh. Again. Shh. Again. Shh. And last one. Shh. Now we're going to put our weights on the ground. And we're going to hinge our body over. And we're just going to bend our elbows and lift the weights up and down. Working those triceps. If you have glaucoma, keep your head up. 4, 5, 5 more. 5. 4, 3, 2, and last one. Now put your weights on your knees and push yourself up. Let's bring our weights out and just open up that chest and close it and open it up and lower your elbows down. Hey, it's time to cool down already. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One more time. Inhale. Exhale. Arms go halfway up and stretch yourself apart. Maybe close your eyes. Feel yourself lengthening and relax. Right arm up, left arm down. Stretch, reach. And back to the shoulders, both hands. Other side, left arm up, right arm down. And back to the shoulders. Rotate your elbows and make a big circle. And one more big circle. Let's just take our right leg and put it over our left. And then take your left hand, put it over that crossed right leg, and turn around and look behind you. And bring it back to center. Go the opposite way. Left leg over the right. Right hand over that left leg. Look behind you. And bring it back to center. Let's take our right leg and stretch out that hamstring. Flex that foot. See how far you can hinge forward till you feel that pain. Just bump up against it. If you can, go all the way down. It's up to you. Now come back up. Kind of shake it out a little bit. Left side. Flex that foot. Bring those toes close to your face first. Hinge forward. And bring it back up. Kind of wiggle it out. Let's walk to the back of our chair. Just put your hands on your lap and just rotate your nose around again. Try and relax. And the opposite direction. Now back to center, look to your left. Back to center, to your right. And back to center. Take this part of your hand and put it right on your forehead and gently press. And relax. Now behind your head, just gently press. And relax. On the side of your head, gently press. And relax. other side. Don't want to be lopsided, right? And relax. All right, kind of work that out.
Whew. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. We love
all
you
right.
So much.
Hope you love this song. One for me. One for me. And one for you. Two for me. And two for you. I love me. And I love you.